Hello and welcome back to the Iron Metal Railway series. In this video then we're going to look at preparing the baseboard for track laying and in addition we will look at doing some track planning and see where the idea for this particular model railway has come from. I've got the material for preparing for the track laying, so I should just open this and then meet you back over at the baseboards. For those of you that watched the previous video, you may have noticed that I've actually extended the baseboards. We'll come on to that a little bit later on in this video, the reason why I've extended it. Basically, when I was track planning, or have been track planning, it wouldn't fit on the 4 foot by 2 foot, no matter. It just looked too crowded, so what I've decided to do is extend it by a further 4 feet. So the layout now, from one end to the other, currently is 8 feet by 2 feet. I've joined the two together. I made them in exactly the same way as I made the first baseboard. If you didn't or haven't seen how I did that and would like to know, I'll put a quick link up now in this video to the second of the videos which covered baseboards and some work I was doing on the Class LA shunter. So in terms of joining the two together, I merely clamped the two, made sure that they were level when I clamped them. And then I've then just screwed the two pieces together. I've checked, there is a slight, I mean very, very slight ridge, hardly anything that you'd notice. And when I place the set cork square on, it shows that it's level across the two pieces and that this one is also level, both in terms of directly across that way and also diagonally. So, hopefully that means that the track will be laid on a relatively flat surface. And what I'm going to do now, I know there's lots and lots of different ways of doing this. Some people I know when I've watched have laid the track directly onto the ply board just with the track underneath the track having a cork underlay on them. Some people lay it directly onto the ply board. I've seen one video where somebody has covered the entire ply with a cork underlay initially in order to make sure they've got a single sort of surface to work on, and that's what I'm going to do in for this model railway, the model railway that we're currently building. I know some people will say that's a waste of cork, however, as always, this is, you know, it's our model railway, we'll build it the way that we think best. So that's what I'm planning to do, and that's what I'm going to cover now. So I'll see you once I've sorted that out. So let me very quickly start by talking about the cork underlay that I'm using. As you can see from the video, the cork underlay that I'm using is Jarvis, from Jarvis Scenics, and it's a cork sheet that is 36 inches by 12 inches by 1/16th of an inch thick, so the thickness is 1/16th of an inch. So I was trying to get 36 by 24 because that would have made up, and I could have just laid one sheet across the whole width of the layout, but at the time that was out of stock, so I've taken the 12, and 2 12s should cover the whole of it, but it will mean that there's a slight join down the centre. But I'm sure we can cover that with other scenic material later. So that's the material that I'm going to be using. I'll now show you how I intend to lay it. Well, here we are then. So my intention is to glue the cork mat into the baseboard top. I'm using just straight Wicks wood adhesive, so PVA glue. I know that I've watched a video where someone did this, and when they put pressure on it, it actually stuck. The PVA glue came through, so I'm going to need to watch that when I'm said doing this, so the PVA glue came through the cork matting and basically stuck the cork matting to the baseboard, but then the cork matting also to the thing that was weighing it down. So we'll try and avoid that as best I can. I've just got the PVA glue, some of it already out in a bowl, and I'm just going to brush this on and see how this goes. I've not done this before, so once again, first for me, let's just have a look how we're going to do this. So I suppose if I spread it on like this, should make life nice and easy. Over, I'll do the rest of it in another second, so let's just get this lined up with the edge. Pressing down so that it sits nicely. What I intend to do now then is just place something heavy on this top bit here for now. I'll just get a book. And now I'll do the other sheet here. So similar process. I start getting the glue. So that it is sticking right up to the edge. Stop that up to there. And now we'll lay this one. In the same manner. Keep that nice and tight edge there. And there we are. What I'll do is I'll trim that edge off if need be at the end. So, that looks like it's going reasonably well. I'll just put another book on there to hold that one down. Try and hold the two together. What I might do is actually place a piece of card along there and then try and clamp that, but it looks at the moment as if the books might be okay and hold it. So, I'm now going to continue that all the way across to the far end. So, once I've done that, whilst I'm doing that, I shall hand you back and we can talk about the track plan and some general ideas behind where the layout is going to be situated and in what sort of time here. So, I'll hand you over now. Well, welcome back. That does look as if it's going okay. Hopefully, at the end of this video, we'll have a look at whether we were successful in sticking the cork down onto the baseboards. As you saw there, we have extended the length of the baseboard from 2 foot by 4 to 2 by 8. And I'll come on to that in a few minutes as to why we did that. I think I explained that a little bit earlier that it just looked very cramped. So, the layout then, let me just get rid of the OH shunter. I hope you enjoyed seeing that running at the end of the last video. I'll just put into the back. So the model railway that we're producing, what's the intention at the end of this? I think I said right at the very beginning that the intention was to produce a branch line sort of Holt station with a good yard and offering me some opportunity to do a little bit of shunting and some freight going through along with some branch line passenger services. I'm hoping that's going to be interested. So where did that idea come from? Well, when I was first having the idea about producing a model railway, I suppose most people, I went out and just bought myself a train set, I suppose, and this is the train set that I bought. So the It was a digital because I wanted to go into DCC, and it was the mixed goods. So that was what I bought. I suppose there was a little bit of me about then trying to make my ideas fit the locos that I got in here. So the two locos I got, as you can imagine, one of my reasons for buying this was because it had a Class 08 shunter, and here's the Class 08 shunter that it had. I'll show you some close-ups of that later on towards the end of the video. And it also had a little Jinty engine, so both from the sort of late 50s, early 60s, I suppose, and very much given the Jinty I suppose I later found out that probably a London Midland Scotland type engine in the main. But then when I came to look at what it was I wanted to produce, I actually wanted something around the area that I come from, which is, I suppose, Great Western country. So I live in Oxford, so it's certainly a Western region engines, and I certainly wanted to run some of the early hydraulics that I remember watching at Oxford Station as we were almost coming to the end of their time, their rather short-lived life on the railway. So with that in mind, I then had to try and make the two things fit, and I'll come on to how I did that probably in another video. But the intention is to run a sort of late 50s, early 60s, towards the end of the steam era, beginning of the diesel era, Western region with a joint track, with joint running rights of the LMS, or London Midland region engines, which is how I can get over the idea of the Jinty running on the service. So that's the intention. Now I then had to look at what it was I might look at, and I was sort of browsing through, and there were a couple of ideas that came to mind. One of those was I found a very useful website that looked at I think it's called the Fairburn branch. We'll have a look at the website in a few minutes. So the Fairburn branch line, and that offered me not only an opportunity to see what a sort of Western region branch line might look like in terms of some of the modelling that I might need to do, but very fortunately it also offered me to look at some of the track plans for those particular branch line stations. So my intention when I'm looking at those was to try and reproduce one of those for this particular branch line, or as near as I possibly can. I wanted it to have a small coal yard in it, partly because my late father was a coalman, so I wanted to probably depict him in the layout somewhere, humping those bags of coals as he did in his younger days, as I remember him. So it would need to have a coal yard in it, so that was going to be part of the thing that I was going to be looking at. So a late 1950s, early 1960s, towards the end of the steam era, running some early hydraulics, a branch line that coming to the end of its time, Beecham about to close it, so a little bit run down, a little bit struggling to continue offering a service. But then I suppose I wanted to work out why the line would have existed, and one of my thoughts, and I'll come on to a little bit of the history perhaps when I either on this video or on a later video, one of my thoughts when I first started looking at it was looking at this magazine called Backtracks, and I came across an article in it to do with called the Dick Cup Flyer, and that was a service that actually ran into a branch line that is no longer in use, although it is now a preserved line, but actually ran across towards Abingdon, where it serviced a brewery. So my thought process there was that perhaps the reason for this line being produced was back in the sort of late 1800s, a local brewer near this particular branch line station wanted the line to be built. And originally, I suppose, there would have been some debate as to whether it fitted the London Midland region, so it would have to be north, whereas the Fairburn branch line heads, I suppose, further to the sort of south-west of Oxford. This had been north-west of Oxford, joining up with another junction station with the the LMS or the London Midland region line running on up into Birmingham, running from sort of Marylebone up into Birmingham. That station also, eventually I hope, when I get some more room to model, will be modelled, and that station is going to be called Moorbank. The branch line that I'm doing is going to be called Little Drawling. Little Drawling because when I was looking at some of the models on the on YouTube and in some of the magazines, there was a little bit of drawling going on there, wishing I could have something like that. So that's why the branch line is called Little Drawling. The overall line is going to be called the Oxford to Moorbank line, or Oxford to Moorbank railway, or the OMR, which sort of rhymes with the our model railway series. So OMR, Oxford Moorbank railway. So what I'm going to do now is to show you, go over to the computer, and we'll have a look at the Fairburn branch line and some of the track diagrams that are on there, and then also have a look at the track diagram that I've come up with in order to start modelling Little Drawling station. So I'll see you across at the computer. So here we are over at the computer, and this is the Fairford branch line that I mentioned a little bit earlier. So this is a line that ran from Oxford right the way through to, I believe it was probably Whitley, and covering a number of small stations on the way. So, and this obviously gave me my initial ideas about what it was I was looking at doing. So I just love the way the stations look. I mean, this particular picture here is just such a great a view, very distinctive, and lots of atmosphere. I just think it looks really, really good. So I like some modelling opportunities around all of this. So this is the type of branch line that I'll be looking at doing for the Little Drawling station. So I did mention earlier that there were some track plans on here, and as you can see, it's a really wonderful website, this particular website. Can't think how useful it is in terms of for us people that there's people dedicated enough to do this in their own time. So here's some of the various track plans, as you can see, and I was, in terms of the type of track plan that I'd be looking for, I was looking at something roughly like Ensham here. So I like the idea of having two platforms with like a passing loop that you can see, and we have a opportunity around the back here to have the coal yard that I mentioned. So it probably would have been an old cattle sort of a pickup point there, but I would turn it into a coal yard. So that sort of idea. So there you can go. I'll just whiz through a few of the pictures here so you can get some idea of the type of stuff. So it was Ensham we were looking at. So here you go, there's Ensham. I preferred the picture of the other one, so I might model the other station. I do like this idea of having a crossing point, so which I will probably continue to have. And there's a couple of the trains passing there. So we'll quickly have a look at some of the others. So if we go to Yarnton, there's Yarnton Junction. I love that shelter there, and that very distinctive looking shelter. That would be nice to model in, and plus the signal box at the rear there. So passing over a token. As you can see, some real opportunities here for me to model. Let's go through some of the others. South Lee. It's an old rail car there. It'd be useful to run a rail car on it. And there's Whitley Station, which was, I think, was the main station on there, on the line. Once again, some very
useful pictures here in order to in terms of modelling. So that's the general idea that we're going to be looking at. A little bit more in terms of the history here, you can see. There's a great picture here. I love this picture here of this class 22 diesel hydraulic here, and you can see at the level crossing here that the crossing gate has been broken, and there's just a bit of rope now that's running across it that the driver obviously has taken down. I just think that's a lovely idea in terms of showing the lateness and how close to closure the line might be. So that's the general idea. As I said, let's go back to the plans. The plan I would be looking at would be something similar to Ensham here. So what I'll do is I'll quickly pull up the idea of the track plan that I'm currently looking at. And there is the track plan that I'm currently considering on the new 8 foot by 2 foot board. This is, which is measured out here. I'm using AnyRail. I did try to download the simple computer-aided rail modeler. I think it's called SCARM. Is it SCARM? But for some reason, my web controller, my antivirus, kept telling me that there was something wrong with it, so it wouldn't let me download it. So I ended up downloading the free version, free trial version of AnyRail. So that's what I'm looking at. So you can see I've extended it slightly this way. There is a reason why I'm thinking of extending it a little bit that way. What I might do though is it does look a little bit complicated here, and I don't know whether to just lose one of the tracks. But let me know what you think in terms of that particular layout. So it offers me a number of opportunities around shunting. Clearly I'll need to work out some of the scenic breaks, both in terms of the right and left hand side, although the intention eventually, I think, is for it to go right the way around, run a circle. I probably would have the a level crossing at the right hand end as you look at it, so the platform end, and try and model some of that. But there's roughly what I'm looking at. Please let me know what you think in terms of that particular layout, and whether you think it will work or not work. A fair few points there that I would need to look at soldering in. But that's the general principle. So I'll just quickly click back to Fairburn there. So Fairford. There's the Ensham layout, as you can see. So it is reasonably close with a little extension in terms of this shed at the far end here. Okay, what we'll do now is we'll spend enough time at the computer. Let's go and take a look and see how the work is going on.
Well, I hope you found that interesting, and I look forward to any comments you make about the track layout that I've suggested, in particular in terms of whether you think that it might be too busy. What I'll do now is I'll leave you with a few shots of my Jinty and Class 08 DCC that I showed you earlier doing a little bit of shunting on the newly laid baseboard cork matting. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video, when we'll actually start laying some track for the little drawing station.